Yeah, yeah. Money on my mind. Money on my mind. Yeah. Money on my mind. Money on my mind. Yeah. Money on my mind. Money on my mind. That's right. Money on my mind. So money is all I think of. That's right. Money on my mind. Money on my mind. Bitch. Money on my mind. Money on my mind. You know. Money on my mind. Bitch. Money on my mind. Bitch. Money on my mind. So money is all I think of. Yeah. Stepping out the motherfucking couch. They in out. I'm looking like a star, bitch. When you see me make a wish, holla at your motherfucking ball, like JR. Birdman, my paw, bitch. Ball brand, born rich. Dear Mr. Toilet, I'm the shit. Got this other haters kiss, cause my toilet paper thick. I know. But tripping at 40, make a chip out of potato head whip. They like brand trash dick. And the hustle was all muscle, just strength.
When it comes to the way I'm struggling, I got 5 years to get one. But we'll see, if that changes how society is over the next 4 years. We're more or less divided or whatever. But regardless of who's president, important topics to cover here. Today I'll get into types of money. Honestly, I'll probably break this up into two videos too, because that's just how the scripts go, and we'll see what we can get through on this one. But before I get into the types, I'll just give a general overview of money, I guess. Oh no. Alright, I'm actually have to cut it on this one, because that marker isn't working, so I gotta get another one. So I got three of them now. I wonder which one will work. Now, you know what? Let's go blue, because it seems like the blue ticket won. Let's go blue on that Biden Harris ticket. Ooh, wow. Yeah, that blue's looking good. Okay, so let me just get onto this first bullet on that script. So, what's money? Or what are some of the characteristics? So money must keep most of its value in time. Otherwise, people would not accept it for payment. This means that money must be relatively scarce, and that the supply of new money must either be difficult to produce or tightly controlled. Any increase in money supply must be gradual and expand with the economy. Otherwise, the increase in total quantity of money will reduce the value of the money, which is a direct cause of inflation. Okay, so that's interesting. Any increase in supply must be gradual and expand with the economy. Otherwise, the increase in total quantity of money will reduce the value of the money, which is a direct cause of inflation. Okay, so if not inflation. Okay. Okay, and the currency itself must also be durable. Like a stone, like gold or silver or something. Okay. I might actually be using this when I put a lot of this video. Didn't think I would use it this much. Okay, so what are the different types of money? Now we can kind of get into that. So there's commodity money, representative money, fiat money. Probably only do commodity money and representative money on this video because it'll take a while, and then the next one we might get into fiat money and electronic money. But first we'll discuss commodity money, probably the oldest type of money. Getting them like grade school teacher hands, like all like markered up. But yeah, commodity money. Okay, so commodity money has intrinsic value. So commodity money is basically like it's a commodity that has, it's something that has a value that's independent of its value as money. So basically it can be used for other stuff, and then like it just happens to be conveniently something that can be used for money. Like, for example, gold can be used in, like, jewelry and, like, watches, or you could put gold in anything because it's durable. It's like a durable metal that you can find and is relatively scarce on the planet. Although I think, obviously, they're finding more and more gold. And you know, we're using it, we're like recycling it into jewelry and then being used as money and whatnot. So, and also silver is the same. Like silver can be used in like industrial applications, like, I don't know, making a sink or something. More like a... And it can also be used for jewelry too. But, yeah, I mean, there's a whole probably industry based on just using silver for different stuff. I mean, it's a durable metal. That's all relatively scarce, I guess. Enough to be used as money. And then also, I was thinking, what about diamonds too? Because diamonds might be used in like chips now. Like how silicon is. So I'm kind of wondering, and then there's even a company that's based in cryptocurrency that's trying to use, they're trying to basically have diamonds as, I guess, that would be representative money. Combined representative and electronic money. It'd be representative money, but then electronic is the interface. But yeah, for that kind of later. But diamonds could even be next as like a commodity money kind of thing. But commodity money, main thing is it usually it's like a metal or naturally occurring substance. Naturally occurring. Naturally occurring substance that has intrinsic value. Independent of its value as money. Okay, and essentially can be used in other things that humans want. That's not money itself. And then also it must be durable, fungible, and we'll go over like characteristics of money, like divisible, probably in the video after the next one. But yeah, it must also satisfy like those requirements too. Okay, so yeah, that's commodity money. Yeah, they just think of it as like naturally occurring substances like diamonds or gold, silver, the main ones, but like it could even be like oil, to be honest. But we kind of, the petrodollar could be like a representative money of like oil itself. Or it could even be like, you know, like tobacco or something. Or usually like that's kind of representative money, because you use paper to represent that. But for this one, you'd probably more think of like a naturally occurring substance like gold, silver, diamonds, things like that. But yeah, that's commodity money. Okay, now we'll get on to representative money. And this is kind of like more interesting, because now like you're bringing in paper and stuff and like notes and stuff like that. This one I have a yacht. Said commodity money is basically like the earliest money. It's like bartering, like it just has intrinsic value, so you don't even, it's just like the actual thing could be used. So you would give someone gold and they would say, okay, I have this gold, I can use it. But then at some point you would just keep the gold because other people can use it. Like, so the, yeah, but if you're just straight bartering, then you would be saying, okay, maybe I have, like these oranges or something. This is just something that has intrinsic value. But, yeah, I don't really want to say like oranges, because I feel like that's just too, I mean, it is naturally occurring substance, but. Yeah, just gold, silver, and diamonds for some reason. I'm just sticking to that. Like, I don't know enough about all commodity monies. But commodity is a commodity. But representative money, it's just paper that represents a commodity, pretty much. Like, I'll just put that down. Paper that represents a commodity.
I want. Steady your hand by two. Take a good view by three. Squeeze the trigger easy by four. Shoot when you're sure.
A valuable commodity. So that's why it can't just be like oranges, unless oranges had a big value in your society. And like represents a, what's considered a valuable commodity. Yeah, usually gold or silver, maybe diamonds in the future. Yeah, so I just put stylized paper that represents fixed units of a valuable commodity. Like notes. Yeah. So whatever happens to be valuable in your society, like for example, if you're in like early America when tobacco is popular, like the Jamestown era, stuff like that, is that's what I remember from school. Like I think they had tobacco notes. So it would represent a certain quantity of tobacco. And then US was on a gold standard, I believe, until like 1970s. So you could redeem that actual note for gold, like at your bank, local bank. Or maybe, I don't know how local the bank was, but relatively, like you could go, or maybe you'd have to go to the Federal Reserve, I'm not sure, but like there was actually a certain amount of gold that you could get for whatever note you had. And then we moved to fiat currency, like in the 70s, which I'll get to in probably the next video. But, whatever happened to be the value in your community, then you could just make notes out of that. And then it was just convenient pretty much, right? Because let's say everyone was like farming cotton or something, like then you could just have like cotton notes, and then instead of just carrying, and then if you just have a bunch of people using that, then you start say, okay, like it's just convenient to trade this for whatever other thing I want. So like I want to get a new like looking glass or whatever. I don't know what it would have been, like looking glass or something. Like let me just, I can give you this amount of, I don't know, something valuable. Like maybe, because if everyone had cotton, it might not be as valuable. But like whatever would be, whatever is valuable. And you would just exchange that and then say, okay, instead of exchanging this, like let's just exchange a paper that represents like a pound of this, or a paper that represents like 10 or you know 10 ounces of this or something, like something that was quantifiable and that could be held somewhere, like could be held, like usually they call it a bank, and like I guess I'll get onto these parts now, that part. So it would have to be, the thing about representative money is that the acceptance of that representative money depends on the reputation of the issuer. So the issuer is the entity that holds the stores of the actual commodity that is being represented by the paper, and then they distribute the paper currency, like they distribute the paper as currency. And they're usually involved with transactions involving the commodity, the currency, and like other people probably. Because they're kind of like the middleman of like, okay, you deposit your paper, you like, you know, everyone's depositing, yeah, their paper at that place, and then they have the stores of the valuable commodity, so they can, you know, be involved in transactions between. Yeah. So the issuer. So the issuer is generally referred to as like a banker or a bank. So, you know, just to keep it simple, like everyone's familiar with that, those terms. So if the issuer creates and distributes more paper currency, because, I mean, if it's printable and they know how to make it, if they create and distribute more paper currency than is representative of the value of the commodity stores, then the reputation of the issuer goes down, and oftentimes people will make runs, or I guess in the old days, people would make runs on the bank to recover their commodity for their... Okay, let me back that up. Let me, like, break that down. So we're essentially talking about inflating the value of the paper here, right? You're inflating the value of the paper, and by, in essence, like, you're deflating the value of the actual commodity being held. Like, so you're saying you're pretending the paper is more valuable than it is, and, like, you're just making more of it. But then in reality, that just decreases the value of stuff. Like, when people figure out, then, like, what you've really done is you've decreased the value of the paper and increased the value of actual stuff. But before people figure out, you increase the value, then the paper kind of means a lot, like, before people figure out. And then, yeah, and then actual stuff kind of means less for some reason, before people figure out. So let me just go through that bullet point again with that little background. So if the issuer creates and distributes more paper currency than is representative of the value of commodity stores, then the reputation of the issuer goes down, and oftentimes people make runs on the bank, on the issuer, to recover a commodity for their seemingly less valuable paper currency notes. Yeah, so they try to recover real stuff for their seemingly less valuable paper. Okay, and then such bank runs occurred I didn't live during this time, obviously, but, like, according to this article that I was reading, bank runs kind of occurred like that in, like, 1700s and 1800s America. And, like, that was back when banks were, like, chartered, and they were chartered and monitored by the states rather than centrally. In terms of the federal government, it was more of a state-by-state basis kind of thing, because think about the communication, right? Like, the communication, like, you didn't even, you know, really know. Like, you weren't so connected, like, to people from the other states at that time. But then eventually the U.S., like, kind of probably with more communications technology, to be honest, the more I read about the history, it seems like as communications technology kind of, like, got more, then it just became easier to be centralized. So eventually the U.S., and, like, a lot of the rest of the world too, like, they moved to a more centralized system with a central bank. Like, for us, it's called the Federal Reserve. And then, so you have, like, the federal government and the Federal Reserve using fiscal policy and monetary policy to, like, kind of control the, like, flow of notes, like, Federal Reserve notes and government bonds and things like that. I'm not an economist like that. Like, I just, you know, I'm a lay person, so, you know, I can't give you details on that, but that's like kind of what I know up to that point. But yeah, then that's, and to be honest, we're on fiat money too, right? So like we don't even, I mean, we're kind of on electronic money, like we're way down now. So this representative money thing, in terms of U.S. history, like it's like in our past a little bit, but like the, but each thing, it's like each next step kind of has remnants of the other, it seems like. So because we still, even on the markets, they still trade commodities and stuff, they still kind of just swap currencies. So but yeah, so I don't even know how long this video is. That will be it in terms of, like, I'll go over fiat electronic money in the next one. Let's just write some more quotes down. Paper that represents a valuable commodity. Acceptance depends on issuer. On reputation of issuer. She's still down and she don't get none of the profit. We're around the city, let the tents hide me. That's a cold motherfucker, whoever inside it. Forever symbolizing the grind, it don't walk to you. I make it run like horses do. Get it, yeah, baby. And then issuer. Hit him up, baby. I know it's crazy, but let's, I can't get enough, baby. I love it, I fucking love it. I'm a self-made millionaire. Fuck the public. I ride to myself cause I don't fuck with nothing. Pistol on my lap on the way to the money. Money on my mind. Yeah. Fuck bitches. Fuck bitches. Fuck bitches. Get money. Get money. Best
get money.
Paper notes. It was good. Let me show you the end of that representative money. This is the whiteboard on that representative.